Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and in this video we're going to start a new series of learning Kotlin coroutine for absolute beginner. If you are absolute beginner in Kotlin coroutine, then this video is for you. I will try to cover everything which is right now is used in most of the companies, and if you want to create any Android application by yourself, then Kotlin coroutine is the most important thing to know, because without asynchronous programming you are not going to create any Android app. So let's get started with our video and try to understand what are the approaches we have previously and what are the benefits we'll receive when we'll use Kotlin coroutine in our project. Let's get started. So first we'll try to understand how our Android operating system will work. So Android is a Linux based operating system, and in Linux we have processes. So all of your application that you are seeing right now in your mobile device are nothing but a process, and when you click any of the icon it will eventually start a new process. So in order to execute tasks in our process, we'll have threads. We have multiple threads and sometimes we have single thread. It depends on the use case. So if you want to execute 10, 20 tasks at the same time, then for that we'll have to create 10, 20 different threads within our process. So threads are resource expensive because it need memory, and also it requires some of your CPU usage. When you create a lot of threads, you'll have to assign a lot of memory, and also every threads will need CPU usage. So let's try to understand this thing with a very simple analogy, a restaurant analogy. Suppose I'm a restaurant owner and I want to run my restaurant. For the time being, I have only one chef. One chef means only one thread. Now, one customer come to my restaurant. My chef goes to the customer, take his order, come back to the kitchen, prepare the meal and deliver it. So it's a very simple flow. Now what will happen if 20 customers come at once to my restaurant? Because I'm having only one chef, so my chef goes to the customer one, take his order, come back to the kitchen, prepare the meal and deliver it. And after the first customer delivery is done, then it goes to the second customer, similarly goes for the third, fourth, fifth. When our chef reaches to the 20th customer, surely it will take a lot of time. And this is the problem with single thread. So to encounter this problem in our restaurant, what I'll do, I'll hire more chef. More chef means more threads. So when we have a lot of chef, surely I have to pay more to my chefs. That means we have to allocate a lot of memory, and also we'll have to give a space, a kitchen space where they can work, right? In Android, we have to allocate all of this thread, some memory, and also some CPU usage. And this is a problem. If you will create a lot of thread, surely it will reduce the performance, because every thread will require memory and some place to work or some CPU usage. Okay, so now I'm gonna elaborate all of this thing with code in my project. So you have to create a new project, Android project. It's a very easy thing. You can do it by yourself. Now in this, let's say I have a main function, okay? And in this main function, for the first scenario, I have only one chef which will manage everything. So every chef has three responsibilities. First, it will take order, mention the customer name, and it will simply print the message that order have been taken for customer one. Similarly, we have to cook the food for my customer first. So I'm gonna again use here println and print the message food is cooked for my customer. And surely if you cook food, it will take a little time. So for that, in order to simulate that behavior, I'm gonna use here thread.sleep. So my thread will sleep for 4 seconds. And if my thread sleeps for the 4 seconds, it will not do any other task. That means it goes into the sleep position or sleep mode. And once we're done with it, we'll have to deliver it. We will connect all of this analogy with coroutine though. So just try to understand the use case of thread, the problem with threads. Why do we actually need coroutine? Okay, so once we're done cooking, we'll deliver it. Deliver it to customer name. So every chef has three responsibilities: take the order, cook the food, deliver it. Now I'm gonna first take the order for customer one, then cook food for customer one, and lastly deliver it to my customer one. So this is for the single chef. As you can see, order taken, food is cooking, it's done, and after that we'll have delivery. Okay, so let's say I have two customer. So for that, again the procedure is same, just change the customer 1 to customer 2. So once our safe will finish with the first customer, then only it will take order from the second customer. So execute it. As you can see, right now it is preparing food for the one. It's done, and after that it will take order from the customer 2, preparing order for the customer 2, and then deliver it. Right now, as I told you, I have hired more safe. More safes means more thread in my process. So let's replicate it. So now I have created a thread. This thread is representing a safe. So for customer 1, I have assigned the safe 1. For customer 2, I have assigned the second safe. So start will eventually start the thread execution. Okay, so now when you click on run button, parallelly it will take order from customer 1, and at the same time it will take order from the customer 2. Execute it. There you go, for 1 and for 2. And food preparation is also start for 2 and 1 at the same time. So if you have more safe, the task will be completed very fast. But as I told you, with threads we have problem. Threads need memory and also some CPU usage. With respect to a restaurant analogy, every chef will need kitchen to work, and also he wants salary. Salary means memory. So this is the problem with thread. If you get more threads, you have to assign more memory, and also at the same time you have to also assign some CPU usage to your thread. Now let's see how we can resolve all of my issues in the restaurant using Kotlin coroutine. Now what I can do, I can remove all of my chef and only hire one chef, and corresponding to this chef I have hired one waiter. Responsibility of waiter is to get to the customer, take his order, come back to the kitchen, create a ticket and assign it to the chef. Let's say I have two customer. So chef says to the waiter, go to the first customer, take his order and create a ticket, assign it to me. Once it is done, chef again says to the waiter, go to the second customer and repeat the thing. So now we have two different ticket. Let's say customer 1 want pasta and customer 2 want something else, which I don't care. So for pasta, we have to boil pasta. Surely it will take some time. Now our chef will put pasta on boil, and he will never wait for pasta to boil. Instead of that, he can switch their task from customer 1 meal to customer 2 meal and start preparing the customer 2 meal. So by doing it, our chef will never block. He never wait for the pasta to boil. He simply switch their task, and this is a very optimal way of using your resources. Now similarly, the same thing happens under the hood with Kotlin coroutine. Kotlin coroutine will suspend the execution if it will take a lot of time, and once the task is completed, then it can resume the task. This is the same thing which I am doing right now with the chef. Once my pasta is boiled, then I can simply go to the first customer meal and start preparing the first customer meal. Same thing happened with the Kotlin coroutine. Now let's see with code what I am talking about in here. So chef means thread. That means we have only one thread. Now only one thread can handle a lot of tasks at the same time. So what we'll do, we'll simply optimize the way of doing things. That's all. We never create any new thread. We'll not create any other things. We can simply optimize our order of execution, and that's it. And this is what Kotlin coroutine will do under the hood. It will simply organize your task in such a manner so that only one thread is capable of performing a lot of tasks. That means a single thread may have 10, 20, 30 or sometimes 100 coroutines. This will surely optimize your performance, and that is why Kotlin coroutine is so popular, because as I told you, thread requires memory and also it requires some CPU usage. But with Kotlin coroutine, it is not the case, because we are just optimizing the way of doing things. That's all. We are not creating any threads. We are not creating any other stuff. We are just optimizing the way of doing my task. Now let's see code what we were discussing for my restaurant. So for that, in this particular example, we're gonna use Kotlin coroutine. So to do that, just use here return type and run blocking. So what is run blocking? We'll discuss later. Basically, all of the things that you will see in here is something which is related to Kotlin coroutine that we'll discuss later. So first thing first, I'm gonna just use here suspend keyword. All of my function will have suspend keyword in front of them. So why do we need suspend function? So right now our safe has ability to pause some execution and switch to another task. So in Kotlin coroutine, you can do this thing only when your function is suspended function. So that's the reason why I'm using in here suspend keyword in front of my functions. Now we gonna launch a new coroutine, basically launch two new coroutine and cut this thing out, paste in here. Similarly for the second coroutine, I'm gonna cut this thing out and paste in here. Instead of using a thread sleep, if you are using a thread sleep, it will surely block your thread. So it will give you the same results that we were having when we were using threads. Now instead of using thread or sleep, we'll use here delay of 4 seconds. Okay, so just remove it, and when you execute it, you can see this block and this block will be executed parallelly. See, at the same time our waiter will take the order and create a ticket to my chef, and at the end will deliver the meal to my customers. So this is what Kotlin coroutine is. So Kotlin coroutine will never create new things under the hood. It is actually used to properly utilize, properly structuralize your operation. That's all. All of the tasks will be executed by your thread, but all of the tasks will be managed properly by your coroutine. This is what Kotlin coroutine is, and also we will call Kotlin coroutine as a lightweight thread. And this thread is also called lightweight processes. That's all for this particular video. So threads are like hiring many chefs. You have to give more amount of money, and also you have to manage them properly, which is very hard. While with coroutine, your one chef can handle a lot of tasks by using smart scheduling. We will meet in our next video. Thank you.